transplant is the process of surgically transferring a donated organ into patients with an end-stage organ failure. As you can see, the organs that can be donated after death is the eyes, the liver, the heart, lungs, kidneys, other tissues, small intestine, and pancreas. A quote from the National Foundation for Transplant says, one organ donor can save 8 lives and change the lives of more than 50 people. Just think about that. In need of an organ and life-death situation, many children, adults, cannot afford it when it's really needed to survive. When it comes to receiving an organ transplant, the patients have to know the risk, the waiting list, and the cost. There will be some changes made into the patient's lives. The patient has to know the risks. The operations can be very complicated, so they have to be aware what might happen before and after. And the risks are infections due to the organ or the medicines that you might have, or maybe the body would reject the organ, and the possibility of not surviving the transplant. Because of the lack of organs, 21 patients died because they're on the waiting list. So that leads to the worst process is the waiting list. And according to the transplant, living patients must be available, healthy, and receive transplant quick enough. So there will be, doctors will make laboratory tests on the patient and the organ. If the first that is on the waiting list, if it doesn't match, then they will go on to the next patient. So that first person is gonna have to wait until there's another one, so they will go on to the second. So from the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, as you can see, 30,973 organ transplants performed in 2015. Next slide. The most frequently one is the cost, and this is the reason why many patients don't receive a transplant. So the cost is before, during, and after the plant surgery. And informed by Dr. Sutherland. Insurance deductibles. The cost includes the insurance deductibles, the transplant evaluation, the testing, surgery, the fees, the additional hospital stays, and others. Next slide. So medications may cost up to $2,500 per month, and the hospital costs informed by Dr. Sutherland. It's $40,000 for a kidney, $55,000 for a pancreas, and about $82,000 combined. Next slide. And here this is from the average from 2011. And the most ones that cost a lot from the transplant is the intestine. As you can see, the total will be $1 million. Some of the health insurance may cover some of the cost, but the rest, the patient will be responsible for their own cost. Next slide. Okay, so today we took a look at the patients have to know the risk, the waiting list, and the cost. But did you know that 12 minutes, another name will be added to the waiting list.